CERT 10th क्लास 3.2 का फोर्थ क्वेश्चन है, क्योंकि पेज नंबर 45-50 पे। ओके, इन दिस क्वेश्चन इट इज आस्किंग विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस आर कंसिस्टेंट और इनकंसिस्टेंट। ओके, इफ कंसिस्टेंट ऑब्टेन द सॉल्यूशन ग्राफिकली। इन दिस वन टू इक्वेशन हैज बीन गिवन टू अस, दैट इज x प्लस वाई इज इक्वल टू 5 एंड 2x प्लस वाई इज इक्वल टू 10। This equation, first of all, what we have to do, we should convert this equation into the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That means the constant term should be taken towards the left hand side, that is x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0. Like that, same 2x plus 2y minus 10 is equal to 0. If you are changing the place from right to left, the sign will get changed. Now it is in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Now in this you will find two equations are here. Okay, now first, instead of taking variable, we have to take the coefficient and the constant term. Okay, what is the coefficient of x here? It will be represented as a1 is equal to 1. What is the coefficient of y here? b1 is equal to 1. And what is the constant? C1 is equal to minus 5. In the second one, coefficient of x 2, coefficient of y 2, and constant term is minus 10. Now write in the form a1 by a2. What is a1? 1 by 2. And what is b1 by b2? That is 1 by 2. And c1 by c2 is equal to minus 5 by minus 10. Numerator minus and denominator minus get cancelled. Again, 5 1s are 5, 2s are. Now see clearly, a1 by a2 is equal to 1 by 2, b1 by b2 is equal to 1 by 2, and c1 by c2 is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, that is 1 by 2. Now, already we have seen in the previous question, before starting the exercise, we have seen that a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Okay, next, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. If you find in this form, then it will be called as consistent. And a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2, it is called as inconsistent. Now therefore, the given linear equations are consistent. Okay, now in the same question, it is asking us to prove graphically. Here I plotted a graph. This vertical line, horizontal line is called as x-axis, and the vertical line is called as y-axis. X plus y is equal to 5. Next one, 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. Now, what we should substitute at the place of x and y so that x plus y should be equal to 5. X plus y should be equal to 5. That is 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. X, y. What we have taken at the place of x? 2. And at the place of y? 3. That is 2, 3. Now, first one. In the second, what we should substitute at the place of x, y so that the answer should be 5? We can take 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. Now, 3, 2. That is 3, 2. Again, in this also, same. X, y. Now, 2 bracket open bracket close plus 2 bracket open bracket close is equal to 10. What we should substitute at the place of x and y so that the answer should be 10. 2, 3s are how much it will be? 6. Plus 2, 2s are how much it will be? 4. 6 plus 4, 10. What we have taken at the place of x? 3. And the place of y? 2. like that. Now 2, 3, 2 2's are 4, 2 3's are 6 is equal to 10. What we have taken? 2 comma 3, that is 3 comma 2 and 2 comma 3. Now we will place this in the graph. For this, x plus y is equals to 5, 2 comma 3. Place the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the y-axis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I am not using here negative signs, so I will not put the negative in this one. Now 2 comma 3, 2 comma 3, what is the point? 2 comma 3, that is 2 on x-axis and 3 on y-axis. Next 3 comma 2, 3 on x-axis, 2 on y-axis, that is 3 comma 2. Now join these two. For joining we required scale. It will be better to take the long scale so that it will be very easy to do. Now join these two points. After joining you will get a line segment. Okay, so it is x plus y is equals to 5. Next 3 comma 2, 3 on x axis, 2 on y axis. Again 2 comma 3, 2 on x axis, 3 on y axis. If you join you will get the same, that is these two are lying on each other, these two are lying on each other, then it is called as coincident, because these two lines will be falling on each other on the same points, it's called as coincident. Now what is the scale for this one? On x axis 1 unit is equal to 1 centimeter. On y axis 1 unit is equal to 1 centimeter. Why we are taking 1 centimeter? The gap between two lines on the graph, if you find the measurement of one cell, it will be 1 centimeter. Each cell is of 1 centimeter, so we have taken 1 centimeter difference. 1 2 3 4 5 6 like that. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, hope everyone have understood. Thank you.